Hi everyone, this is Dr. Revati. Today we are going to discuss about nth order linear differential equations of second and higher order. In the same concept, now today we are going to discuss about what is the particular integral, how to solve the solution of particular integral. In this rules for finding particular integral. First of all, how to take the form of particular integral means f of d into y equals to q of x. This is the form of the particular integral. Here, particular integral pi equals to 1 by f of d into q of x. This is the form of the particular integral. Now, case 1 of the particular integral, how to solve means here. Now, suppose the function means here f of d into y equals to e power ax. Then, particular integral pi equals to 1 by f of d into e power ax. Here we have to substitute in place of d means a. Here f of a is not equals to 0. Here particular integral means solving for the given nth order differential equation is non-homogeneous, and then right hand side can arranging in the functions of x. In that type of equations only we have to solve a particular integral. In the solution of non-homogeneous differential equation means y equals to yc plus y equals to yc plus yp. This is the solution of non-homogeneous differential equation. In this non-homogeneous differential equation, solving both the functions, complementary function and particular integral. Now let us take one example here. That is, first problem is solve d square plus 5d plus 6 into y equals to e power x. This is the one of the non-homogeneous differential equation, because in RHS means functions of x here. In this both solving a complementary function and particular integral. According to process of solving for nth order differential equation, the given differentiables, first of all we have to take operator form. Already this problem is your operator form, so we have to first find out here complementary function. Complementary function means first the given equation we have to take means f of d into y equals to d square plus 5d plus 6. Next, now finding a complementary function means auxiliary equation a equals to 0, that implies f of m equals to 0. In terms of m, the given operator form we have to arrange in terms of m, that is m square plus 5m plus 6 equals to 0. Here we have to finding the roots, that is m square plus 3m plus 2m plus 6 equals to 0. Next, this can be written as m into m plus 3 plus 2 into m plus 3 equals to 0. Here m plus 3 again common. Now this can be written as m plus 3 into m plus 3 into m plus 3 into m plus 2 equals to 0. This can be written as m plus 3 equals to 0 and m plus 2 equals to 0. M plus 3 equals to 0 and M plus 2 equals to 0. M equals to minus 3. M equals to minus 2. Therefore, CF equals to YC equals to C1 e power minus 3x plus C2 e power minus 2x. This is the complementary function CF. Next of all, we have to find out the particular integral. Particular integral of the given problem is rule number 1. That is 1 by f of t into q of x means here a power ax form. Sorry, e power ax form. That is x. Here a means 1. Here in place of d means 1. That is a. Here a means 1. Okay, substitute that equals to 1 by f of d means d square plus 5d plus 6 into e power x. That equals to 1 by in place of d means 1 plus 5 into 1 plus 6 into e power x. This is 1 by 12 e power x. This is the particular integral PI. Next we have to write the solution here. Y equals to YC plus YP. Y equals to YC plus YP. Therefore, Y equals to YC means C1 e power minus 3x plus C2 e power minus 2x plus 1 by 12 into e power x. This is YC plus this is YP. Also, Y equals to complementary function CF plus particular integral PI. This is the solution of the non-homogeneous nth order differential equation of second and higher order. Okay, thank you watching for this video. Thank you.